river down the way.
Oh, they're beautiful.
Oh, docks? Yeah. These go out the river too, docks. They have kind of red scam, big ones.
You'll see them all over.
But what's good?
Red. Take these seeds,
brush them up on a stone,
and then make flour. I made black bread seeds. It's so many uses for docks, man. The roots are used for liver problems, blood purifier. The seeds are used for bread. The leaves are used for cooking like spinach on also raw and salad. Telling you a lot of stuff, huh?
Yeah.
Remember, those dock leaves also, they're like astringent. They'll stop any kind of insect bite or mosquito bite. It'll really be good for us.
As far as that astringent stuff, people go on anaphylactic shock or even altitude poisoning. So, like, you need plants to help you, like, regulate blood pressure.
Garlic. I take garlic.
Yeah, and ginseng for high altitude. Like, when I'm going to the high Sierras, I'm taking American ginseng a lot for my lungs. It oxygenates your blood there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and ginkgo biloba too. Mm. Yeah, ginkgo, garlic, and ginseng. I'm taking those almost every day. I took ginseng this morning. American ginseng, panic. That's good for your lungs.
English. I don't have the other species with me.
Well, this is Quintet. Well, it's in the park.
Yeah, I know. That's why I figured you'd show it later anyway.
Right here.
We have two species.
Anyway, this is plantain. This is Plantago lanceolata. These seeds are used like Metamucil for a laxative.
Also library?
Yeah, and the leaves, young, can be used in salads while cooking them. Also, they're good in poultice medicine for dislocated bones and pain reliever for joints and arthritis. And these grow here, higher up elevation.
They're by the swamp gate.
Yeah, they're by the swamp right down the street.
They're in the flax family, so the seeds are like flax.
Yeah, you can buy the leaves. Also, it's a laxative. The leaves too, dry cake.
And a food substitute.
And a food substitute. There's some in the park right now.
We'll walk around and show you.
Yeah, this plant, this grows here in the Sierras too, yarrow. Way famous. In China, it's used for I Ching for telling fortunes. Instead of the coins like they have nowadays, they use these sticks and they shake and throw them on the ground. Yeah, they have teeth. Yarrow. Ling, lang, lang. How it got its name is from Achilles. You know, the ancient Greek general. It's called Achillea millifolium. The leaves are like millions of little leaves. But man, you make flowers in your tea and drink it. It gives you energy and stamina. It's blood purifier. But the thing I use it mostly for is cuts and wounds and bruises. Like, it stops bleeding almost instantly. We're out
make
in the woods.
Powder it and put it on there.
Just
put the leaves on.
That's why the Greeks used it for battle.
They would actually sew it into the wound and leave
it.
Yeah.
And it stops infections and the pain. When you get a little, if you get a bad cut, put this on. There's no pain, no infections, plus it stops the bleeding.
What's it called?
Yarrow.